To start with, I think I should give them opportunity, everybody, to introduce themselves. Eliza, start with Eliza. Thank you.
My name is Eliza.
Hi, my name is Johnson.
Hello, my name is Felix.
I'm Mama Vicky.
Hi, I'm Jessica.
And I'm Bea.
For you, but if you're never gonna change the world, if you're never gonna be a movie star, if you're never gonna change the world, maybe you're looking too hard. Don't synthesize her.
I have a question first to all these members of Growing Up African. Why did you do this show?
No, boy.
You have to respect both
no,
of
them. No, boy. Boy,
boy, I don't have to
talk.
Boy, are you supporting this?
Wait, did you drink a little?
Growing up was kind of tough. And
so the first week or the second week I stepped foot in America, niko mama, nataka kurudi nyumbani.
You probably know a thousand ones like this.
Mama bado naongea. So mama bado naongea. Samani.
It's like a puppet.
Look at your neck, that was a good one. Yeah, it looks like a puppet.
Mama bado naongea. So mama bado naongea. Nitakupiga sasa hivi. Nenda ubadilishe shati. We gotta get mimi nataka kupumzika.
What the fuck?
Boy, panini, you got it. Let me talk.
Nini umesema I'm fat?
Oh my god. Hakuna. Matara.
Watch it. Now you're finally welcome back.
Matara. Oh, do welcome back, man.
I'm a dreamer.
Everyone deserves to earn. And every child deserves to learn.
I am an achiever.
I am ambitious.
Each and every one deserves to earn.
I am confident.
I'm adventurous. I'm growing up African.
Throughout all this show, I know you have done a lot of shows in the last 10 months. If I understand it correctly, that this show has been on for the last 10 months.
Yes.
And you guys have reached out almost the whole world globally. And I know that this show is being watched a lot in Africa, especially in Tanzania, Kenya, and Uganda, East Africa. What message have you guys gotten back from the, you know, from the people, you know, concerning the shows you have done so far?
The strength in the show is the idea. Since the idea started, everyone loves the idea of the show and where we're trying to get to. And people do understand that we have growth and we have a long way to go, based upon like production, sound, and those things. But people love the idea. And when you usually start with a good idea, everything else falls into place. So we're not saying we're perfect people now. We might not dress the best. We might not have the most money. So, but as we go on, we'll get better. And right now, we just like that people like the idea. This is something that's fresh, something that people haven't seen before. Yeah. So that's what we like. They like the idea, but now, especially going into our second season, it just can't just be a good idea. Now it has to be a good show.
Down, only got a gallon in the gas tank, but I'm almost at the finish line, so I can't stop now. I don't
one point Mr. Johnson came up with the idea of start doing the show. What it took for him to convince all of you to do this show?
What the fuck? Boy, what do you mean? You can cut it. Let me talk. It's a man. Oh, maybe no, my eyes are now umma, so I have to close them. What's the problem? I swear.
Yeah, like,
oh,
yeah.
No, macho na umma.
Just make it a little
bit. I know. Yeah. I usually have to do that first, and then I am not boring. I'm not like you.
I'm boring.
Also, another thing, you have to remember that day what was going on in your emotions. You were scared that Travis is the person who always likes to be on time. Everyone was running late, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't much more of like a convincing, because we've always like worked together as like a family. So it was much, like, I guess the idea was not spoken among all of us. We had the ideas, and from like watching other television shows here in America, we were like, you know, like, that could be us. We could do that. So when he actually said it and our mom was like 100% behind it, we made sure that we all got together and put it into work. So it was like a much easier transition than trying to sell it to us, because we all like wanted to do it.
In this family, although we do regular jobs, I think we are kind of artistic, because we, like, a while ago we had a group, dancing group. We always try to do things like that. Like, sometimes I do write, and, you know, we are in entertainment. We like to be in the entertainment industry, although what we do every day is not entertainment, but that's, I think it's in the blood.
Last season, we had different things going on, from having this huge wedding, which everybody still is talking about until today, to Bears going out in the city for a fashion show, to Boy doing his own thing on the football field. Eliza had us going I don't know where, and then me with my new car, and then Boy with his, the little boy with his big party going on.
You're growing up African, right? Unaangalia nani episode gani? Kitu gani kimekuvutia?
Mimi nilivutiwa na ile kwenye ile wedding.
Wedding.
Sembo food nilifanyia nyumbani, kucheza ngoma za Kiaya.
Aha. Wewe Mwaya? Au ndio maana amevutiwa kwa sababu huyu Mwaya. Kitu gani? Na ugambe Kiaya?
Ah.
Kumbe kitu kiko gamba.
Like Mwanya. Sio sio tu.
Wewe Mswahili?
Mnyamanga.
Mnyamanga. Hi, asante.
Why did you do this show? What was the reason to start doing this show?
We basically started out with Johnson, who came up with the idea. He wanted to create a show because, like,
how
Africans live in America, and also, like,
there's a misperception of, you know, how Africans in America live. So we wanted to show it's not just, you know, what the perception of Africans. To, like, it's not, we don't live in a little bubble, you know, we are very diverse, and that's what we want to show.
You basically just want to break the stereotype barrier about how Africans live. That's what you were trying to say.
Yeah.
Well, Michelle and Nagawa, and then you were killing Kamilash.
Should I talk fast, or should I just like...
No, make it short. Coming up next. Da-da-da-da. That's it. So,
two sentences.
It's more interesting.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Boy, Ebukana, come on.
I'm telling you.
Boy.
It has more flavor to it.
You need to tell the whole story.
Boy, we know your taste. For your taste.
What does that mean?
You don't have. So, for your taste. You go by what you tell.
All right, the 32-year-old single is coming at me.
I'm single for a reason.
And I'm not.
Can you just... Coming up next, please.
Coming up next is the family photo shoot. That's it. Because people don't
coming
want to
stop next,
talking.
The family photo
boy,
shoot.
Nani, come on. Unangala TV siku nzima. Coming up next.
The second, the one
just
I did before.
No, coming up next. Coming the, up family next the family shoot. Photo shoot.
With excitement, please.
All right. Coming up next is the family photo shoot where you get to see us in
no.
action. That was perfect. It was
okay,
not too
so
long.
Room,
oh my god. Go ahead. Say it again.
I gotta lick the lips again. Alright. Coming up next where you get... cut. Coming up next is the family photo shoot where he gets to see us in action.
Please stay tuned for season 2. I was fixing myself. Okay. Please stay tuned for season three. Hi everybody, welcome back to Growing Up African.
These are the Growing Up African sisters.
Bea,
Eliza,
Jessica.
Thank you again for staying.
Oh my God.
Do you guys live together? How is the setting of you guys living?
Well, the setting of the living situation goes like this. Eliza, Bea, Johnson, we all live in this beautiful crib. And the baby boy with our moms, they live together. They're almost like a couple, a married couple, because they have like a love-hate relationship.
No, we don't.
So you have a love-love relationship?
No, we don't.
No, you
we
work, have a relationship.
What kind of relationship would you consider it?
We work hard, that's what we do.
Yeah. Oh, okay, that's understandable. And then, Jessica lives solo.
With her husband?
Yes, I do. Huh? I live by myself in Long Island with my friends, my college friends.
I don't live with my mom. We live together.
No, he lives in my basement.
I have my own apartment.
What, you pay rent?
In my house.
What, do you pay rent? Do you pay rent? The question is, you pay rent too, you work hard.
I cut the grass, I take out the trash.
You have these chores.
No, you don't. You're not gonna, we're gonna wear a bright shirt.
But the color is too dark.
Wear a bright shirt.
I like the shirt.
Oh, Ebu, wear that shirt. Because right now my patience is running very.
All right.
Nitakupiga sasa hivi. Nenda ubadilishe shati. We gotta get, mimi nataka kupumzika. Kwanza sijalala.
Yeah, I have to go to work.
Okay, get up. Fanya haraka na hawa watu naona. Sasa hivi wataanza kukoko.
All right. Yeah. We're just gonna put on my work shirt.
What about your work shirt?
Yeah, it's bright. Okay, what am I supposed
to do? Sit up.
What are we talking about?
What am I supposed to do?
You're the camera guy.
Yeah, you look in the camera person. And you make sure it comes out right.
But I don't know.
Press record.
I press what?
The record is already pressed.
I need to sit down.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
You gotta signal us.
Nimewaambia hivi,
that means be quiet.
I'm on one.
This show is about African. I think the main theme should be African.
Yeah.
And I would like to hear from you guys, what is your connection, African connection? Which
maybe
you?
I should answer that first.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. The thing I preach, I think I preach, I don't know, you know, if other people do the same, but I preach these guys, I preach them to have the connection back. Like when my mother was still alive, she died like a year ago. I made sure they called. Every weekend I would call and say, you guys, you need to call your grandma. And they stay connected with their father. The father is back home. They stay connected with their, what do you call it? Extended family. If there are weddings, even if we cannot go, we contribute money and send it.
My dreams for Africa is to, especially for young kids, to have exposure. Like the exposure we get here, the opportunities we get here, you know, the basic things, like you go to Tanzania and only like, you know, certain people with money have those opportunities. And here you don't have to have money to have the basic needs, you know. So that is my, you know, I would like to see, like, you know, the same for Tanzania. For Africa.
My dreams for Africa is basically to have like the younger generation to be more of like entrepreneurs, where they go out and like figure like what they're good at, if they're good at music or if they're good at anything, any creative side of them that they're good at, they could turn into either like a business or helping out other people. So like Africa could be a better place, just not only
My dream man is
a successful man, by successful meaning, of course, he has to be educated.
Has to win three fights.
Come from like, cause from like a really tight family, so family is very important. It has to be family orientated, and looks aren't that important.
That's a lie.
Oh, so you don't mind an ugly man?
That is a lie. Maybe it might be ugly in your eyes, but not ugly in my eyes.
Sure.
But he has to be physically fit.
Oh yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like you're physically fit.
I am.
Yeah, okay.
And. Again, what Eliza said, like, he has to have respect for me and himself.
Yeah.
Respect is the, it's the big key.
Okay. And now, Eliza, what kind of man is your dream man? I mean, you guys, you gotta understand that, you know, people back home are watching this and
stuff. Oh, so then somebody will be like, oh,
Okay, great.
Mama would love to know.
People are looking to do the application, you know.
No, I don't know.
He's talking directly to the camera.
No, I don't, like, I'm very...
Eliza, take anything.
No, I'm not saying it. I don't know.
Well, what's your dream man?
Eliza, you're stupid.
You don't know the menu.
I know. I have an actual list, but I can't
think of it. I have a list by now.
No, no, my type is like, you know, like, very earthy people.
The one
like,
that drops you off and runs off.
Like, you know, with like Afrocentric.
That sounds like Rajabu. Okay, Jessica, you know, what's your dream?
I don't know. He has to be educated.
Okay.
Looks wise.
Accept you.
What do you mean accept me?
And your eyebrows.
Uh-huh. Yeah, they have to respect, accept who I am.
How should they look?
Huh?
How should they look?
Like, he has to be taller than me.
Gotta have
when I'm in heels. Because I would want to wear heels.
I'll take a short man.
No, he has to be tall. I can't do a short man. Yeah, okay. He has to be tall. Freckles. No, just kidding. nicely fit. Okay. A little bit bigger than me, but has to be fit.
That's it.
Yeah, that's it. Same guy.
Okay, I think, you know, I think that you guys had, you know, the ladies, what they are saying, that are, you know, I mean, seriously, the ladies are looking for an educated man, you know, physically fit man, respectful man, and, you know, I don't know if all this has anything to do with African or Tanzanian.
It doesn't matter.
But it sounds like it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
You see, in this world, we don't discriminate.
No.
You know, that he has to be Tanzanian or African. No, no. You know, you heard from the ladies that they're looking for a man. You see, a man who is, you know, whatever they say. And now, let me get this next to the two big boys.
Oh,
you see, now Mr.
The
boy, you know, there's the same question from the ladies. You know, what kind of what is your dream lady?
Heartbeat.
Well, you know, I'm going to censor this because my mom is in the room.
Okay.
I just want a simple, honest girl with a nice personality.
Okay.
Gotta be clean, personal hygiene.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice teeth.
Fun personality, she can't be boring or dull because I would lose interest.
Okay.
And she gotta have carriage.
What?
Huh?
Carriage. Okay. Now it's that was little boy and now it's time for the
carriage
big boy.
Just that
big boy, let's go, man. What's your dream woman?
My dream woman,
Tiffany.
My dream, she has to be alive.
Okay.
What's that supposed to mean?
Like, all right. This is my dream woman. Let me think about it. My dream woman, because I am getting a little bit older. She can't have kids.
Oh yeah, that's number one too.
Yeah, she can't have kids. She can't have a boyfriend or a husband. She has to be single. She has to respect herself. She almost gotta be almost in the same type of like, almost like type of industry or same lifestyle that I have. That's really a big thing. So if someone is like a homebody, they just like to stay home, I don't think I can talk to that person. I travel a lot, so I'm just gonna have to talk to a person who's either willing to live in the States or Tanzania or wherever I'm going. So I'm just looking for someone who's who looks good. And then, you know, can travel and, you
open-minded.
Know.
Open-minded.
Yeah, and handle my family because.
Yeah, we are a lot.
Yeah.
But what's if you don't look kids? That good, it's okay. I will take you with me. Mm-hmm. But if you don't look that good, you have to be able to handle my mom, my sisters.
No, we look good. Don't worry
about that. They'll talk about you. They will talk about you.
No, we'll fix that. We'll fix that.
You're ugly. If you're ugly, I love you. But my sisters.
No, we'll give her a makeover.
My mom.
No, no, I don't have time for
my
that.
My mom won't even hug you if you're ugly. Don't worry about it. You're with me.
I have in my kids. You're with me. If they have kids, it's okay. What's wrong? Yeah, what's wrong with that?
It's not his kids.
I don't care. What's wrong with the
she kids? Just wants their grandkids. Mama, when they have their kids, you're not going to be able to be holding them like how we have
ours. So if they will come with kids, that's fine. Then I will,
she'll, or no, they're going to be on the other side.
Suppose the kid is like 12.
Grandkids. Red maid.
Suppose the kid is like 12.
No matter.
Okay. You started, you lied.
Okay. I think, you know, you ladies out there had, you know, the two big boys.
The what? Whole thing, you were looking down. The whole thing, Yanni. Eliza was even.
You have to look up.
Yes.
I'm just walking.
No, even Eliza. Eliza was so much better.
Yanni,
Eliza and the children.
Wait,
where can
no, you can't even. What's up? You can't even. You can't even. You
can't even. You can't even. You can't even.
No, I'll be fine. I'll be fine.
The best way for us to be able to represent Tanzania, East Africa, Africa in general is for our show to become successful. That's going to be our easiest way. There's other things that, yes, we do want to do, but the best way for us to be able to expose Africa is by telling our story. This is the major reason why we did the reality show, to be able to showcase what Tanzanians are, and then when we start visiting Tanzania or Uganda or Kenya or Nigeria, different things, then people will get that exposure. But we first want the show to be successful, we want everyone to watch it, and as we progress and we become better, then we can start exposing, you know, other causes that, you know, especially like things that my mom wants to do.
Okay.
My next job is to make sure your transition back, I mean, not like you're gonna go live back over there, but when you come back to Tanzania, that there is somewhere you can, you know, come and stay and meet all your distant relatives, whatever. So my number one project is called Kyango Project. That's a house in the village, but we wanna make it so nice that when you go there, you still have the same amenities, you're still comfortable, you can bring your friends, your wives, your little kids can come and have the same kind of life here, but they're still in the village.
Oh, thank you. You know, my name is William Malecela, you know, as usual, the Mutu's man. So, follow me on the Facebook and Twitter, you know, I'm there. And, you know, we are working together, we are all Tanzanians, you know, nobody's bigger than another. We are all struggling, we are all trying, and, you know, we are working together, people, you know. Support this group, then this group grows bigger. It will always give back to you, give back to Tanzania, to the village, to the kids. You know, we can entertain each other, you know, rather than just thinking one way or the other way. We can always mix the thinking. So thank you very much, and thank you, Eliza, boy, Jessica, little boy, Mama Vicky, Bear, you know, thank you for having me in this show, and,
thank you guys very much.
Stop that, boy, what are you doing?
You need a paper towel, you're sweating
on. Hold on, boy, get out shadows.
That's how the light's gonna make him sweat, look at him.
He's not sweating because of the light, he's sweating because he's fat.
Hey, come on.
Hey, Cody. Shut your mouth.
And this gonna walk right behind. Hey. Excuse me.
What the hell?
And then that just.
Okay.
Yeah, and that pandan
gas.
And a pandan gas. Where pandan gas? No.
I can climb very slight.
Okay.
Yeah. Check
pandan gas.
I don't know. Miraculous.
Jody's not here.
Huh?
Go ahead, Jessica.
What's my snuggie? I'm sorry.
Stop that.
What?
The dish rattling. Please.
She thinks he's attractive, so I was hoping there was some. Why not check on Ali Mambo up?
I already did it. Talk about shit. We don't need 22 minutes. Step for some.
Okay, talk about how our dressing cover was taken.
It's like a carpet.
Look at your neck. That was a good one. Yeah, it looks like a bug.
Okay,
this one is natural. This one, ears are falling off.
No. Top 10 funny hairs. Yeah, you're right under Donald.
It's a Monica trend.
Alright. Am I saying the same stuff?
Yes.
Yeah, you guys don't help each other's confidence at all.
No. Yes, to cut it.
Don't be jealous.
He's pulling a bang.
What does that mean?
A bang.
She's getting on you. A bang.
Wait, can you see my hair? Because I didn't take
your
hair.
Yes.
My hair in the back.
It's great. And your little red lipstick. That's all we see.
What? Hello. Okay. One.
Hi. Welcome back.
Hey, welcome back. This is Eliza. Thanks for supporting us. For the next. What am I? Umone boy, that's not funny.
It's okay. Okay, I'm ready. So we thought. Oh my god. Akuna, Matada.
Welcome back, man.
So, Bea unaongea.
Start over, Samani. Don't tell me what to do. Okay, so the dresses,
just say it's not your fault, the dress you could wear. Like,
can I just say what I want to say?
Hi, everybody, welcome. This is you gonna speak.
No, it wasn't.
Okay.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Growing Up African.
These are the Growing Up African sisters.
Bea.
Eliza.
Jessica.
And we thank you so much and welcome you back to season 2.
There's a lot in store for you for season 2. Please stay tuned. You will enjoy the show. A lot of things that were not revealed in season 1 that you will get to discover and explore in season 2. There's a lot of surprises. Okay. I'm the one who's gonna be looking stupid, so let me look stupid on my own.
You don't look stupid. Right? Yeah, it looks like
of course, with any great parties, there's always finance. And of course, with the finance, with family, it always comes out short. And I always have to come out of my pocket to make up for the rest of it. Though we
Oh my god.